Hi, Carol here. A warm welcome today to my craft room and a warm welcome to my American subscribers that are celebrating Thanksgiving Day today. I hope you're having fun with friends and family, and I just want to send out a happy Thanksgiving to you. Today we're going to do an invisible shaker, and we're going to start with the Tim Holtz alteration die. This makes the accordion flowers in two sizes and also gives you two sizes for the middle of your flower, which we will use the larger of the two. I find when I made this that the medium weight acetate works the best, and it gives you the flexibility to bend up the accordion shape and still be nice and firm on the inside, and I will show you that actually. There's nobody else working with me today. And isn't this a long video? Are my videos getting longer? What? I couldn't believe it. 44 minutes. But honestly, I did three of four sides on this card. And when I do that, it's very hard to edit it down. So I apologize for the length. And like I always say, you can speed it up if you like and just see the ending. So I'm using the paper tray ink kit for shakers. It has heart shakers, oval shakers, the inside and the outside elements. It's a wonderful kit by Paper Tray Inc. It came last year. It has so much in it. You can look it up. I'm not sure if it is available, but what I like, not only the sentiments are all in there, tons of them, but there's this foam board that has sticky on both sides, and it raises up even your sentiments. It's wonderful. And I'm going to use these poinsettia dies. Now, this is poinsettia ribbon. It's mainly for going down the side of a card. And I love this one because there's four poinsettia stackables. And this ribbon one is wonderful too because the guts come out and you can change the colors, which is awesome. I turned this over right here. It's the Bloom Trio, so you could see exactly the numbers and things. And if you have any questions, just leave it in a comment for me. This is the ribbon set 99182. I can see that. And I'm going to use my Big Shot Pro because it gives me a lot of room to die cut a lot of die cuts at one time because it's so long and wide. And I'm going to take all of these poinsettia dies and I'm going to run them through on both these pink sheets, as many as I can get cut out. And I'm also going to use it in silver. So I sped it up here and look at this double-sided board. I absolutely love that. I know Paper Tray Ink sells this separately. And if I can find it for you, I will leave it in the description box. But you, for your sentiments, it lifts them up. You don't have to, you know, put many, many stacks of paper to get the height you need. So I ran this through, and these dies, the paper and even this board falls out wonderfully. Like, I really wasn't struggling. It looks like I was, but I didn't want to tear anything because it's very delicate. So it just fell out, and I'm going to take all these pieces, parts, and I'm going to lay them aside to start the card. And I have to tell you a funny story. As most of you know that watch my videos, I have pneumonia and a bit of bronchitis as well, and I've been really laid up quite a bit this past week. And I was laying there about 4 o'clock in the morning having one of my coughing fits, and I'm thinking of what kind of card I can make, and I'm telling you, this card came to my mind on doing an invisible shaker and putting an invisible acetate center in and then making it a shaker so you can't see where all these shaker bits are going. And I thought out the whole, you know, like I knew it was going to be an accordion flower and da 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 da. And yeah, when I woke up, I wasn't sleeping. I didn't dream this. Oh dear. No, I didn't dream it. I was wide awake. Yeah, I was coughing, you know what it's like with pneumonia. And if you've had it, excuse me, if you've had it. But anyway, this whole card came to my mind. I mean, everything. And then I thought, I hope I remember this when I wake up. But I did. And I couldn't wait to get started. So even sick, I wanted to get this card out before, you know, it just got left to the wayside. And it was so much fun to make. So now I decide to use, I think this is a Stampin' Up! Sparkle paper, actually, because I bought quite a bit of that years ago. And here, I don't use this setup, but I wanted to show you my, when I go to cut my card, because you know I like to make large cards, I set out, I actually design it on the cutting board so that I know how much to cut off. Because you don't want to have to, you know, you can always work with too much because you can cut it down, but you certainly can't add to it easily. You can add to it. I do it all the time. But, you know, not easily. So I saw this. This isn't what I did, by the way. It was just something I thought, okay, I could do this as a shaker. And I liked it. And so I kind of played around with all different ideas, where to put the sentiment, where to put the poinsettias. And if you, I wanted to leave this in because it would give you an idea. It looks gorgeous on black, and I didn't use black. I kind of wish I did use it as the front, but I didn't. I thought, okay, I'm going to go with a deep burgundy Stampin' Up! Paper. And it's from an old stock. I'm not sure what it's called here. And I used a Martha Stewart flower punch. And it works very well. It really, for a thick cardstock, because this cardstock is rather thick, it went through really well. So I was really happy with it. And I knew I wanted to punch the top and the bottom. So the upper portion and the lower portion with flowers. And then I thought, okay, what if I put vellum on top of it to kind of blur out the deep, dark color? But all I had was the Stampin' Up! 40-pound weight, and really it was too much of the paper, and you know, you couldn't see through to see what was underneath. That's the point I'm trying to make. It was just super heavy weight, which I love, but you can't see through it very well. So I didn't do this either. But I thought, I'm going to show it to you. Just if you want to do a card like this, it certainly looks beautiful. Here I'm fussing with the accordion flower. I put the glue or the double-sided tape on the one side so that it would be ready when I had the card ready to set up for you and we would decorate it. A lot of times if you make cards, and obviously you're watching a card video, so you're all card makers, and you're the most wonderful, wonderful subscribers. Can I just jump in and tell you how much I appreciate you and your comments? And I try to comment on every single person's wonderful comment that you leave me. I really do try. Sometimes it won't go through. I don't know what that issue is with YouTube, where it just rejects the comment to go through. So if you don't get one, it's not because I didn't try. I always say that in the video because it makes me feel bad, you know, when a comment doesn't go through. But thank you, everybody. You are amazing. Now that I have this cut in half, I'm going to make it book form. And it is 5.5 by 8. That's the measurement of this card. I cut this to 2 inches, and I'm going to use the same punch as in the burgundy cardstock on one side of this 2-inch cut, and it's quite thick, as you can see. You should have seen me using my punch. Watch this. This is hysterical. I got it down. Oh, yeah, big muscles jumping right up in the air, and then I had to take my scissors, and actually, I was risking wrecking this die. But I wanted to have the same the same cutout as in the card. Excuse me. And here I am just pounding down on that thing and then taking my scissors and getting it in there and plopping it up. Here I do it again. I'm thinking, one of these times, Carol, that is not going to work. You're going to be out a wonderful bunch. But there goes my scissors. And yeah, I just, yep, boink, it comes right back up. So I clean that up, and now we have one side with a wonderful straight edge and another side with the same punch out image. Now I took this mini scoring, I'm scoring it here right along the line as close as I could get, And then I used my Teflon bone folder, got a nice crisp fold, excuse me, and I decided I wanted a gusset. You know, I always put a gusset if I'm doing a card like this because I'm going to do elements on the inside. I decided to do three portions of the four-sided card for you. And so I added another, I took it back out and I scored it one over just a tad so that I had that wonderful gusset along the side of my card. That way I could put anything, you know, a little bit with dimension on the inside and I wouldn't risk the card always opening. But we're going to use magnets anyway. Love magnets when you use an oversized card like this to shut it. I think it's a wonderful, wonderful element for any size card. And this is, like I said, 5.5 by 8. I use double-sided tape on there and I leave the gusset blank. Obviously, that little six, I think it's a 16th of an inch. I leave it white and then I cut it off to the shape of the floral punched out image so it looks nice and clean. And I add double-sided tape to this side, even though it has the holes in it from the punched out image, you can't see it hardly at all, really, using the double-sided tape. So I use two. And it worked out very well, making sure that my gusset was free from tape. You don't want to have anything in the gusset at all. And then cut it off and then put the other side of the card on. And it really does. You can use it lengthwise or you can use it lengthwise. Looks wonderful on this style of card. So I'm removing it here. I'm going to take this. And when you do this, I'm going to suggest that you, see how I put that on top so that the punched out flowers run all the way across in the same order and that the cardstock actually looks the same because sometimes cardstock can be lighter and darker on each side. So you want to check that out before you lay it down and it's fastened with the tape that you have it both on the same color. Before it goes down. And now I am taking that wonderful double-sided board. It's an actual board. It's very thick. And I'm taking the silver oval that I cut out and I'm going around it just to make sure none of the sticky is showing. I take the Copic marker, as you know I always do, and I go around the inside edges of the actual sticky board so that you can't see the white on the inside. And we're going to set this now on, well, we're going to put down the scallop one, excuse me, on top, because we cut out the scallop sticky, so which makes it wonderful. You have the sticky on the top of the board, you have the sticky on the bottom of the board, and you don't have to worry about gluing. It's wonderful. So I get this all set up, and you do want to be careful. I'm going to try and get that board in the description. You will, description bar, you'll love it. And now there you have the top and you have the bottom. The scallop is for the top and I'm going to take the back off of this oval and I'm going to put it on the vellum. And the reason why I do vellum with this shaker is because it tones down the deep burgundy. And I just go around it with my scissors as close as possible. And what I like about it is you take your stylus and you rub all the way across your vellum and then it tones it down again so that it brings it down a shade to see through. It doesn't look so white. And wait till you see it. It's wonderful. I do that right after this. I take the back off my scallop and this is going to be the top of the shaker. So I just set it, plop it right on top of some heavyweight acetate. And there's your shaker. Easy peasy. It's finished. Look at that. Boink, boink, boink. Isn't it wonderful? And then I cut around it just at the top of the scallop. And then later on, I go in and I detail it. I go in the little edges so that it looks really, you know, really nice. You don't see any of the acetate. I like to get it really detailed in there. And look at that. There's your little shaker, and then we're going to add three layers of the tape to make it three high, and raise it up. That's what it worked out to be, three high, with our accordion flower in there. Isn't that so pretty with pink and gray? So I'm going to put this down, and I added tape to the entire thing so it wouldn't move. Then we're going to set it down, and I was thinking of going that way, and I said, nope, we're going to go lengthwise and towards the bottom. And then once you get it down, take that stylus. Look at that. Isn't it wonderful? It's just like coloring. You're just pressing it into the cardboard of your cardstock, and look at that. It's just beautiful. And it makes all of, I'm going to use Prills, and they just roll around beautiful on vellum. That's the object. There's my accordion flower. I'm taking some double-sided tape so that I can secure it so it's, you know, it goes round and tucks in. Then we'll take it off, and this is the start of our invisible shaker card. I was so pleased with this. I love these accordion flowers. I don't get to use, I should use them more often. I certainly have enough of the dies to, you know, the accordion dies. They're so pretty. Now, what I did to secure my flower down is take one of the middle parts that we die cut, and I put a nice piece of double-sided tape on it underneath, and then I lay the flower on top of more double-sided tape on top of the vellum. Then I grab the smaller portion and tuck it in the middle so that all of the tape that's under there will not prevent the prills from strolling in and out of each of these mountain folds on this flower. The prills go inside and outside, and they travel all over the place. And if you have it in the right direction, you can't even see the accordion flower because it fills up with the prills, and it looks stunning. If you tip it to the side, the prills go out of the accordion flower, and you can't tell, you know, really that it's there. And then when you move the prills, they go into all of these valleys and hills. It forms a flower right before your eyes by filling up all of the sides. It's so pretty. And now I'm taking my dimensionals, excuse me, my glue dots. They're not dimensionals. And I put them all the way around in a complete circle before I put down, just to double secure it. And then we'll put this accordion flower down in the center, and then we will move to put that round piece in that middle. You want to take your stylus here and press really hard so that the acetate is bedded down into your glue dots and that they're even. You know, your valley and your hill go up and down, and you have even space for those prills to run in and out because you have the center empty except for one little bead. I put a bead in there so if somebody got this card, they were younger, they could kind of shake it up and down and the prills would go in the bead on top, just for like a little bit extra fun. And I'm going to grab, right now, I'm going to put baby powder in the center after I put my magnets. Just sprinkle a little bit of baby powder or your static powder and put it in. I'm just showing you the numbers. These are the only magnets I will use on my projects, are these magnets. So I left the number for you. And I wanted to just show you that to make sure that you put your powder in the center, because we put a lot of glue dots in there and you don't want it to be sticking the prills. You want that movement of the prills. So lay down, here's the magnet issue right here. Love these magnets. I get them at Sharon's store, but I know you can get them online. And they're the best magnet I have found. Super lightweight, super, super thin, and crazy magnetized. They're wonderful. So you set a positive and a negative down, one on the inside, one on the outside, like that. Put your glue dots on each side when you're ready to use it, and you're all set. I'm going to take my T7 gray Copic marker just to go over the inside so you can't see any of the sticky. And we're going to put that metal piece down after we take our anti-static powder and really pounce it in the center so that you don't have any sticky, and the prills can go in and out, in and out, in and out of all the valleys of this wonderful acetate flower. And I'm putting the pink down inside here, and look at that, making sure that they run freely inside and out. They go from one hill and valley to the next hill and valley. So pretty. Now, to add some interest to the center, I grabbed the bloom, just the outside piece. I took the guts out and just added the pink in the bottom, the silver on the top of that metal bead, and it raised it up and it gave it some interest. It still allowed the beads to go in and out of the hills and valleys, and somebody can have so much fun just playing around with that. And now we're going to put the acetate lid on there. So this ended up being three layers high, super, super thin. I cut that roll of double-sided tape extra thin, and I went around and stacked it three high. That was perfect to allow you a little bit of room between those flowers and the shaker itself. I'm adding some powder on the inside so the prills don't stick to the inside, as you can see right there. I'm going around taking the sticky off of it with the anti-static powder, and then we're going to set it down. And I really do love this card. And wait till you see what we do next. It even adds some more beauty to it, because I don't like to see that tape on the outside. So we remedy that, and we remedy any chance for those prills to come off. excuse me. There you have it. Isn't that gorgeous? And then the more you play with it, the more you fill in the flower, and it becomes a flower just before your very eyes. For the second time I'm saying that, because I was like playing with it so much. It was amazing. Anywho, yeah, I love what I do. Take quite a bit of the hot glue here, and we're going to use this brocade ribbon that I cut in half, because I wanted to have the scallop, but I wanted the scallop on the top to touch the scallop on the card glitter paper, and this will eliminate the look of that tape. I don't like seeing that at all, so that remedies that, and then your prills are never going to come off, and neither is the top of your shaker. There's my orange. It's my vitamin C. I keep having coughing fits, and I figured I'd grab a tangerine and eat it while I was doing the video. So put quite a bit of glue in here and take some, this is brocade ribbon, and I just cut it in half. It had the, it actually had the scallop on each side of this brocade ribbon in silver. It's gorgeous. It sparkles just like the paper. And then I go around making sure that my glue is secure. I take my stylus, and I make sure I work it in the top and the bottom underneath the scallop on the top and secure it to the bottom so no prills escape. It gives you that same silver look. You have double scallops. I mean, how pretty did this turn out? I mean, I'm not bragging. I'm just saying sometimes what we do surprises us and it ends up prettier than we ever thought possible. And I just really like this card, and I think it'd be nice to use it for a birthday, actually. So yeah, so you can see how I tuck this right underneath the scallop sparkle paper, the glitter paper, and I kind of push it along and make sure that it's all nice and even, and then I grab a little bit to secure the edge right onto my stylus, poke it in there so it's you know, smooth all the way around. You want it to look smooth and yet be very secure. Now comes the fun part of decorating. I absolutely love it. When I get done playing with it and I put it down, we can decorate it. I decided to put tiny little diamonds on the flowers that we, the Martha Stewart punch on the sides. So I grabbed some of the delicate diamonds, and then I put my glue dots on top of my magnets so that I can start to decorate there. And it's just the little bit of detail that you add to your cards that make it so extra special. It's taking the time to think through the card. And I know it takes a little bit of extra effort. I do know that. But when the recipient gets this card, I think they know it's not from a store. Let's just go that way. You didn't get it from a store. You had to have it homemade, right? And I love adding as much detail to cards as I can possibly think of. And I'm using that small one. And then I grabbed my small little pearls to add to the same. Remember, we punched the top of this out so it has the same flower. So I decided to go diamonds and pearls. I think they look gorgeous together, don't you? Just adds a little something-something to your card, I think. And once we get that done, excuse me, we can move on to decorating the entire card. I just give you a close-up. It's so pretty. And here's when I start to relax, because most of the card base on the front is finished. I put down my Sparkles cardboard double-sided tape. I didn't want to have to show you the agony of that. Then I cut out a white piece to put on top of that because I wanted to raise it up just a little bit more because the actual shaker is high. So I wanted to keep this up just a little higher. So I thought it would look special to have the cardboard, which is high enough in itself, the sticky board that you get from Paper Tray Ink. And then I cut out another piece in white. I put that down. And then I'm going to use my multi-purpose glue to put the pink sparkles that we cut out with the sparkle paper. And we'll put that on top. So there you have it. And then you have to remember to keep that little dot on sprinkles. It's so pretty. I mean, you're sprinkling prills in there. And I just love the font on this. And now we just add, we're going to cover these magnets with the poinsettias. So whatever you like to do with your cutouts, whether they be poinsettias or whatever you cut out, just cover the magnet so you can't see them, obviously. And I wanted this to be an over-the-top glitter card, just over the top. And I think I achieved that. Don't you? Yeah. And diamonds and pearls and sparkles and glitter and pearls and sprinkles and brocade and magnets and punched out flowers. I mean, you got it all in here. Look at that. It's just, I love these poinsettia dies. And then I add one of the blooms and put the actual magnet just inside one of the flower petals, because I'm going to add the pink and then the guts will be silver, and then we'll cover the magnet with that, and I think it looks just wonderful. Excuse me. And then we'll add another one up in the corner so that you have three. That's why I like to cut out, die cut a lot of elements at the beginning, because I never know how many sides of a card I'm going to do. For sure, I'm going to do the inside and the outside, but sometimes I get carried away and do the top, the bottom, the back. You know, I just goes on and on. I just get so involved in the card that I can't stop. Obviously, right? You can see that in this card. And it's only 5.5 by 8. It really isn't that big. I've made bigger cards. I've made like 8.5 by 8.5, and I think 5.5 by 8 is a lovely size for a shaker card myself. And so we're going to do three flowers. And I love the way that when we put the pink down on top, I don't think we showed that. But when I put the sparkles down I didn't glue it down. That's what it was. There it is, like on the top. I'm glad that I didn't, because I wanted to show you to set it just a little bit off the side so that you ghost the font. So the sparkles has white underneath and pink on the top. I'm adding the multi-medium glue because it sticks very well and it dries clear. And I grab my tweezers and we're going to put that on top of Sparkles there and just pull it a tad over to the side so you get that little bit of ghosting effect and it really stands out. I love that it's white on the burgundy. Just a beautiful font, isn't it? Just really pretty. And the multi-medium glue sets very fast. Well, moving right along, we at least were almost to the finish line. We're almost there. So I take this gorgeous cutout. Isn't this poinsettia? It has all of that intricate inside pieces, elements to this poinsettia. I love this set. And I'm going to lift it up because I want to cut one of them off. It looks a bit congested up there. So I take one of the petals completely off and it looks so much cleaner when you do that. And another thing that's really great, I'm going to show you in a little bit, that you can make out of a poinsettia that looks gorgeous too. So let's cut off one of the petals there. Yes, isn't that much better? Put it way up there. It gives you a little bit of space where the S is in sprinkles. It doesn't look like it's jammed in there. Just like that. Oh, so pretty. Oh, so delicate. Love this poinsettia set. It's just scrumptious. The inside, all so pretty. And this one on the top, it's just delicate. It's just delicate. And talk about glitter. If you want a glitter card and you want a shaker with a whole lot of fun elements, I think that we found it today. Well, this just about concludes the front of the card, and then we're going to move on to the inside. Now, what I did with that was, see the silver oval that's on the actual shaker? Well, I ran the acetate through on the frame that had it was a dotted frame, which I really liked, and I thought it would make a nice element on the inside of the card to have the acetate showing on the oval. So that's what we're going to do next. And I think I'm pretty satisfied with all the glitter on the front. And now we're heading down to the finish line for sure. One thing I like about an oversized card, if you don't want to make an envelope, I like putting them into baskets if you're giving something as a gift, or a bag, like a brown gift bag or a matching bag. You could always do a bag. I think I have a tutorial on one I did with a matching gift bag and card. There you have it. Isn't that sweet? I love playing with the prills. So that's one idea for you. And here, I never trust my eye anymore because I thought this was even. And when I got my T-square ruler out, it wasn't. And that's one thing I want to make sure I maintain, is everything is even on the card. And so the T-square ruler comes in very handy. And I just put a glue dot on the top, a glue dot on the bottom, and put it down. See the little dots going around? Isn't that sweet? And then I put glue dots on about every fifth scallop on this frame. Then we're going to turn that around. And this is pink, the pink glitter paper. And we're going to put that on the outside of the acetate. Oh, I'm sorry. It's the silver. Wow. Yes, it is the silver. And then I chose to put the silver gut pieces when I die cut these images from the front of the card. So I grabbed that, and why not just glitter the whole inside out? Excuse me. And sorry. So I'm just going to add some liquid glue to the back. And we're going to seat that right there, and then I'm going to put sprinkled. There's a sentiment die that says sprinkles and sprinkled. Isn't that sweet with that acetate around the center? I mean, there's little elements that you, like this would make a nice front part of the card as well. And the same thing with my sentiment. I grab my ruler because I'm telling you, you think it's straight and it's not. And I actually thought this was a tad bit crooked with the D like that, so I did straighten the D up. But when you put your ruler down, it doesn't lie, especially a T-square ruler. And that, you know, that was even right there. So I left that like that, and then I grabbed this poinsettia die and I cut out the bottom, just one portion right there. Let me see. And I made it a butterfly. Upside down, yeah, so that the little poinsettia blooms were at the bottom and the larger ones out to the side. And yeah, that really made that those tiny magnets that I showed you, these are the ultimate magnets for cards. And then I grabbed my pearls to make the antennas on a butterfly. Isn't that cute? So it's twofold. You get to have a poinsettia flower, or you can move and cut out one of the you can tell it's getting late. I'm starting to cough. Soon 7 o'clock hits. I start with the congestion and the coughing. But anyway, yes, it looks just like a butterfly instead of a poinsettia. And then I do the same on this opposite side. I'm trying to cover the magnet on this side, so I make the flower just a tad bit smaller. It looks more so like a flower bloom than it does a poinsettia. And then I added that right there because there was a little speck on the paper and I wanted to cover it up, put a diamond on there, and we're all set. Now, you would think that I would stop right there, right? Oh no. I thought, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to get out my stickers, those stickers. I have 1,000 of them there. And I love to use them for two reasons. I like them to straighten out a card if it's a tad bit on out a little bit. This will help you to even it up. But I knew I needed something right there, and I wanted it to be white. Silver, excuse me. Sorry. And so I put this down, and I thought it really did add something to the inside of the card. I didn't put one on each side because I thought the butterfly was just perfect there. And I love using these stickers up. They're only $2.50 a pack, and they really do add something to a card. Then I grabbed another one here that's, I think, if I'm looking at it right, it is silver as well. And I put that in the center on the gusset. Instead of leaving it all white, this is just a hint of pattern, which looks really sweet when you open up the card, and they stick wonderfully. They have really, you're able to lift it up and correct it, but once you lay it down and it's seated there for a little bit of time, they stay permanent. They're just wonderful. Love these stickers. So can you see how it's just so subtle, but yet really nice? And then if you want to move it, just slide your Poke Tool underneath, and then you can, I needed to move it up just a little ways, and this works very well. Now, I know what you're thinking. Good night, Carol. When are you going to be finished this card? Pretty soon. But you know what I had to add? I had to add an opener. So I grabbed some of my cord. It's silver cord that I had in my stash. Cut a little piece off. Put some hot glue there. Pulled it into the brocade fabric, and I just shoved it right in there, and now whoever receives this can grab it like that and open it with that little wee piece of cord. I thought it was fun, different, and gave me something to do. And now for the back of the card. Yes, I had to add some black. There was just something about the card that I had to do the back, because you know I like my cards really thick. I could put pages and pages of cardstock on my cards. I just love it. So I'm just making some little marks, and I'm putting some double-sided tape on the back, and I'm going to seat this because the front of the card is so heavy with the weight of the shaker element, the inside element. And so I thought, you know what, I think some black would just add some elegance to the back of the card. And then we just have a few more things to go, and this will just about be complete. Can you believe it? And I'm just making sure that it's even. And then I'm going to add some more stickers. Why not? Right? Why not add some more things? Once you go this far, it doesn't matter. You can just add anything you have in your craft room to the back, and it will look really sweet. So I have these little black stickers, and they're just like little ovals. And everything on here has an oval. And I thought these stickers are little ovals, so I put one on the top of the black cardstock just because it looked so stark. Watch when I peel that off the pattern. It's just subtle and it's oval. So it does match. It matches beautifully, actually. So I added one to the top and I thought, you know what, after I cut it off, I'm going to add one to the bottom because it makes it look like it's perfectly even. Like the paper is exact. I like that look of being exact and just having a little bit of something on the card. And I think it's an overtop card anyway, right? It's way over the top. But I like doing cards like this and it's enjoyable once you get started. I had a little bit of black cardstock I need to take off on the bottom. And yeah, really thick cardstock. Look at this. I had to work at it, but it's nice and straight because there's no way I could put it through the... Look at that little... I love the opening on that. And then look at that. Do you think I could leave that plain? And you know what I didn't do? I didn't measure it. So you can tell that it's over to the left just a little bit. And so when I get finished with this edit, I'm going to add a little something just over to the right because I can see it as I'm doing the edit and that will drive me crazy. So, and I couldn't leave it plain because that would drive me crazy. So I thought, when I get finished here, I didn't notice it at first when I was finished the card, but as I'm looking at it doing the edit, oh my, yes, get that T-square ruler out, Carol. Because see, my eye thinks that's in the middle and there's no way that's in the middle. No. So I will be putting a little something, just probably a little smaller pink flower off to the right. I feel like I should have had chapters. Look at that. Isn't that nice? Can you see the ovals in those stickers? I just love it. So there you have it. You're going to see the first hand all this crazy glitter. Open it up with a little cord. You have a butterfly made out of poinsettia. And you have that little bit of tiny element to the gusset. And we have completed the card. And I'm going to remind you to put your name in for the 5,000 subby for the album because I'm going to complete that hopefully tomorrow. And then December 1st was going to be when I'm going to pick the winner for that and for the candle pincushion. So I can leave that in the description. So you can just pop over there. Thank you so much. I'm almost at 7,000 subscribers already. And that is a real blessing to me. Thank you, everybody. You've really made this journey special for me. You have yourself a blessed week as we look at this card. I hope some of the elements give you some inspiration. And I hope it was entertaining at the same time. And look at this. I'm even thinking of putting more bling on. Get it off, Carol. Get it off. No, I'm not going to put that on. There you go. I'll put a little something just over to the right. And thank you so much as always. And I will see you tomorrow on the next tutorial. Now that I'm feeling better, I can get some projects out there for you. So take a look at this. I'm measuring it for you. It's 5.5 by 8. Take care, everybody. Enjoy the pictures. And we'll see you on the next tutorial.